Okay, these are some problems from section 9.1, and the first ones are these little series that you have to figure out some missing components. And the first one is replace a star with the expression that will generate the series. So this is my series. Oh, I don't have it. Didn't write it down, but it was 1 minus 1 over 4. I guess I should write it up here, I guess. 1 minus 1 over 4. Plus 1 over 9, minus 1 over 16. I guess that was the series. I guess it was just, yeah, plus dot, dot, dot. So I started with this. They gave you this, and they wanted to see what this little star was going to be. The star was here. Well, this negative 1 to the n minus 1, this is a nice way of generating alternating series or alternating signs. When n is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, anything to the 0 is 1. When n is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1, and that's going to be negative. 1 to the 1 is negative. And when n is 3, and I put my, I kind of wrote kind of the fractions and what I had and put my n's underneath here so I could kind of keep track of this, because we usually have this in terms of n. So when n is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2, so negative 1 squared is positive 1. So again, 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, negative 1 to the third is a negative. So it generates alternating signs. Okay? And if we look at this, so this gives me my alternating signs. So it looks like I've got pretty much the tops all done. And the bottom, it looks like I just have 1. And I can think of this as 1 over 1. Given to you. It wasn't given to you like that, but you could think of that as 1 over 1. And if you look at the relationship between these bottom numbers and the n is 1, this is 1, n is 2, that's 4, n is 3, that's 9, n is 4, that's 16. So it looks like we're just squaring the n's. So it just looks like this gives me my negative sign, so just 1 over n squared. So your star was just n squared. And you can always check it out by writing out the four terms, and this summation will generate these four terms. Okay. Letter B. Again, we have the same idea, so I wrote these out. But in this case, my index starts at 0. So I'm going to have 0, 1, 2, and 3. So I take a look at this, and again, I've got my alternating signs, so that's all the same. So I'm just looking at the bottom here. Now, n is 0, so it's definitely not going to be 0 squared. All right? But what I had was 1, 4, 9, and 16. And again, that was 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared. So relative to 0, 1 squared is 1 more. 2 squared is 1 more than 1. 3 is 1 more than 2. And 4 is 1 more than 3. So I just took my n, whatever my n was, and I added 1 and squared that. So it ends up being n plus 1 squared. 0 plus 1 squared is 1. 1 squared is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 squared is 4. Okay, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 squared is 9, 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 squared is 16, so you can figure it out like that. And unfortunately, you just have to try these. You may not like that, but that's the way it goes. All right, and then the last one here, or the C part for this first one. Again, we had negative 1 to the n, and we wanted to figure out what the index was going to be. And a negative 1 over n minus 2 squared. Now, I know I'm going to have a gap here. I'm going to have a problem when I've got 2, because if 2 minus 2 is 0, so n can't be 2, so I can't skip over that. So my best case scenario is what if n is 3, so I'm just going to try different values and see what works. So I put these in, and I started with n equals 3, and to see if this generates what I wanted. And indeed it does. If I put 3 in here, again, I can't have it 2. So I got to start at the next possibility, which is 3. 1 to the third is negative 1, and I got negative 1, and then I put 3 minus 2 is 1. 1 squared is 1. And a negative times a negative is positive, so I generate my first term. When n is 4, negative 1 to the fourth is positive, and I got negative 1 over 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 squared is 4, so I get 4, and I get a negative. And then these are kind of slanted over because I didn't give myself enough spread there. When I n is 5, which would be my third term, n is 5, because I'm starting at n equal 3. When n is 5, negative 1 to the fifth power is negative, so I got negative 1, and then I got 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2, which is 3 squared, which is 9, so that's okay. And the last one, when n is 6, that's going to be a positive, so it's going to be a positive. This negative times a negative gives me a positive. And then when it's positive, because there's a negative sign there, it gives me a negative. So that's a negative. And then 6 minus 2 is 4. 4 squared is 16. So it does generate that series. So the index was going to be 3. All right. So a little bit of work on those, just for one problem.